Decided to come to La Jolla for the weekend. I'm staying in a van on the beach, and it's pretty sweet. But yeah, I've learned that every time I'm really overstimulated or exhausted, I just need to take a quick solo trip, and I feel a million times better after the weekend, so that's what I'm doing. Got a bunch of old tattoos that we are in the back parking lot of Melrose Sound, where I made the Bright Side of the Moon song and the Good Things Take Time EP, and I'm about to just show you around. Oh, it's not so bad. Just
look on the bright side. It's the right time to it's the best tea maker in the game. Just immediate hot water, I don't know. Close my mind. So we are at Melrose Sound, more specifically the Red Room. If you can't tell by all the red aura. I would say my absolute favorite memory is I had never worked with Ahmad, who produced Bright Side of the Moon, and then Sam Fisher, who helped me write Bright Side of the Moon. And I came in and I was like, okay guys, I have this idea of a song called Bright Side of the Moon, and I want the EP to be called Bright Side of the Moon. And after we wrap the EP, I want the tour to be called Bright Side of the Moon. But I haven't written Bright Side of the Moon yet. And I kind of like explained what I wanted the song to be about, and then it just like all came together really quick. And that's what Bright Side of the Moon is today.
It's my favorite part.
This little guy right here.
I always thought that was awesome.
I spent, quite a few hours in this room right here, sitting in this chair, singing into this mic. So here we are on the crowded streets of Sunset. This is a Roxy. This was the first venue I played at in LA. First, like, with Chelsea Cutler, and then I hit it again on my headlining run. That tour was like, the start of it was literally just like a culture shock for me. I had never toured, I barely experienced, you know, going to shows that size, so I really had no idea what to expect. This was like my fourth show ever, and I was shitting my pants for the show, just because like, all the industry people in LA come, all your friends come, and this was like the first show I threw up before. Which is embarrassing, but whatever, it happened. But anyways, we pushed through the show. It was a great show. And then afterwards, literally right here was where I met Quinn92 for the first time. And we chopped it up for a second and got to know each other. Then, you know, a couple months later, he asked me to join him on his spring tour. So a lot of good memories of this spot. We're going to Chino Hills for the mustard bloom, the annual mustard bloom. It's not a super bloom this year, but it's still popping. But we don't know. We don't know if there's even going to be any yellow flowers.
Tell me a little bit about your relationship with your friends and your teammates during quarantine and how they've helped you grow.
Yeah, I mean, I live with two of my managers, and my producer is my other roommate, and so it's pretty like in-house, and there's always, you know, music talk going on, and they kind of saw when I was having my bad days.
Joe! I was trash, fucking trash.
And when I was having my good days, and they were really the ones to kind of be like, hey man, like, we don't want to see you like this anymore. We want to see you happy and really doing what you want to do. It was only one time I was obsessive, a little compulsive, wondering what it'd be like without you.